Hello, Apple Valley Fab Lab students. It's Mr. Lee, and today what we're going to do is send a file to the print and cut machine to make a heat press t-shirt vinyl. First thing that I'm going to do is take out the sticker vinyl that we have in here. I'm going to put in heat press vinyl, and the difference between the two is the heat press vinyl has a paper or a plastic backing, where the sticker vinyl has a paper backing. So that's one way to tell the difference. The other way to tell the difference is to, sometimes on the roll it actually tells what kind of vinyl it is. So what I'm doing right now is putting the vinyl underneath these pinch rollers so that it feeds in through the machine properly. The other thing that I'm checking for is to make sure that a sensor is covered by the vinyl. What happens next is the machine actually measures from pinch roller to pinch roller, and that's the print head doing that right now. So you can kind of see the process. The pinch rollers that I'm pointing out are right here, and then the other one is right there. So the effective width that we have is about 18.5 inches. That's why they call this a BN-20. The full width is 20 inches if we didn't have the pinch rollers. The next step is to open up the software that runs the machine, and that's Roland VersaWorks. I'm going to load in the PDF file of the image that we created in the last video. What I have to do next is I have to tell the machine that I want to cut it, and I have to tell it a couple of other pieces of information. So I loaded it into QB. I'm going to pull up that, so I double clicked on it. And the first thing that I notice is that it has this marquee, the red marquee, marching around it, and that's a good sign. That means that the cut contour is correct. I can also look at the size of the image. At 100%, it's about 11 inches tall, about 8.6 inches wide. I don't want to have anything much bigger than that, or it'll tuck into your shirt. So that's about the right size. Looks like I can get one print per row. So I'm going to get the media width. It changed just slightly. I could rotate this and then probably print two. So if I go to copy and change it to two, yeah, I'm probably going to do that because the amount of ink that gets used is pretty insignificant compared to the price of the paper. The ink costs about 40 cents per milliliter, and the paper is, or the vinyl is about $2.50 to $3 per linear foot. So we're going to use about a foot of the vinyl. Looks pretty good. Next thing I'm going to check is the quality. This is going to take 16 minutes to print. I go down to cut controls. I have the advanced settings set up. Pressure is about 100. If I wanted to cut the blue border, which I don't, I would select the cut image boundaries. This is ready to go. So I'm going to click OK. On this machine, I can hit the third button over, and that creates the file to send to the machine and turns it into the machine code. And then the machine starts printing. So I'll hit print. It's gonna take about 15, 16 minutes. It's going to use about 0.64 milliliters of ink, so about 25 cents worth of ink. It will take a little bit longer than 16 minutes to print it because it has to go back and cut. So I'm going to pause the video now, and then we'll pick it up again when it's almost done printing.